So welcome to you, Mihai and Adina Stoian from Nata Yoga Center. You just held a lecture downstairs about tantric couple relationship, about how to transform a relationship into a tantric one. And first of all, I would like to ask you, how would you define tantra?
Well, it's a quite difficult question for a small talk. We can say tantra is the science of a spiritual life. How to live your life in an integrated way, in full awareness, and in the same time without the necessary blockages, taboos, limitations which we put to ourselves when we don't have any other solutions or answers to life's multiple problems and multiple choices which we receive. So I would say Tantra is a science of our life and with which we get back the richness of it. Or with other words, we get back what is ours by divine right and we forgot about it in this labyrinth which we call life.
Adina, can you explain a bit how to apply this knowledge, these teachings in a couple relationship?
Couple relationship is, at least for the feminine side of the humanity, one of the most important value. And understanding Tantra is also a science of controlling the energy and understanding that energy is everything in the universe. Couple relationship is a modality of making true and real the dynamics of energy and the play between masculine and feminine. Thus, it comes quite natural to integrate the tantric principles into developing a harmonious and fulfilling and happy couple relationship. And for us, it came also quite natural, because starting individual, our quest to know about ourselves more and to work with ourselves in the terms of building up the energies and controlling them and discovering more about who we truly are, we also became lovers. And then we could see that completing each other in terms of nuances of the energy, we could reach the wholeness of our own true self faster and easier. So I would say this is how we work with the tantric principles within a couple relationship. And then for me personally, it was very touching because I have experienced so much happiness and so much fulfillment and such a great life, then I want everybody to know that there is a chance also for couples to have such a thing.
Could you give us a few practical examples of what you have been going through in your tantric couple relationship? What you have been doing?
Well, first, I think we went through like any couple, not necessarily a tantric couple, through the problem of the relationship needing certain answers and finding these answers within our couple relationship. Such as, for instance, the jealousy problems, the possessivity, the attachments, the tendencies, the superficiality in approaching intimacy, the control over the sexual energy, which was a big ongoing lesson for us. So yeah, these were elements we were facing from the very beginning. And for me, for instance, was a big lesson to face Adina, because she is a volcanic woman in a way. As I sometimes joke, I say she is a natural phenomena. And you need to to be at the same size, so to speak, with this natural phenomena. Also for her, I noticed probably there were some maybe challenges, but what I have discovered soon after we started to build up a kind of conscious relationship is that always a relationship between two people who love each other is posing the necessary lessons which they have to learn. So actually you never have problems in the relationship, you have lessons, and these lessons are always fitting with what you need. So practically it's a mistake to avoid the lesson in, or a challenge in a relationship, to say, look, this is difficult, I don't want to have this situation in our relationship, because practically you learn from it. And it's something you don't learn in that relationship, you will learn in another relationship where you face the same problem, or you will face it in the daily life with other situations. Because through resonance, you always attract these problems you are facing inside. And, but the relationship, in a very mysterious way, is taking these things out more easy. So what you, for instance, hide from yourself for years and you don't want to face, in a relationship you almost cannot hide. So it's the naked truth there.
But Adina, could you give some practical examples of, for instance, how to overcome jealousy and all these kind of things that no one really likes to have in their lives?
So how did I do it?
Any example, I mean, something that you did overcome.
For me, it was a matter of experiencing it again and again. And of first of all, of not running away from the pain of it, but of staying there and face it and see that it's not as horrible as I would expect, and as practically speaking, and that came doubled with an effort to center myself into the depths of how I've found my heart and myself, and to kind of gather my energies and my strength around this true center in which nothing is lacking. And it could be, I did this with maybe all the problems I had, and I found that it's like an universal solution, because when you go deeper into your soul, not necessarily even to the peak of ecstasy, but even closer to your heart, you will start feeling more and more complete, and therefore you will not need another one to define yourself, or another one to feel your own value, or another one to certify who you are. And all this would be like roots of this possessiveness. And also with the knowledge came the understanding. And that had to go through many practical repetitions, practical applications, which were less and less painful until they are under control. To my big amazement, I cannot say that feelings, the human feelings, go away. So imagining that jealousy will disappear, it's exactly as imagining that rainy days will not come. Rainy days, as jealousy attacks, can come, or storms, but if you are protected, then you can be protected in many ways. Even not being naked in the rain is better than being naked in the rain. The same with the jealousy. Instead of being hopeless there and crying and screaming and feeling to throw yourself out of the window, it's better off standing on your head and be a little bit more focused. So, and to continue my analogy, better than standing in the rain dressed is having a raincoat, better than that is having a roof above your head, and better than that is living in a palace. And then rain or storm or tornadoes cannot affect you so much. You notice them, you can see that they are coming, and then I go to find my refuge. And as far as I can go in myself is analogically as closest to the palace I can get. And then I'm more and more protected.